Hey guys, Trent Wetzel here. About a year ago on YouTube, I uploaded two videos. One of the Asus Nomad backpack, another of the Asus Rogue G750JS model. Those videos got quite a bit of a turnout for me. Obviously, I don't have those computers anymore. As you can see, I switched to Apple. But today, I'm here to hopefully further my YouTube career, maybe get some views, and hopefully help you guys out, and maybe when you're looking for the newest tech or anything like that. So today, I brought with me the All-Tech Mini H2O Rugged Speaker. They claim that it's everything proof. Waterproof, sandproof, rustproof, dirtproof, snowproof. It can go on. It's everything proof, right? Hopefully I'll be able to put that to the test and we'll unbox it here for you. Let's take a little closer look to it. Alright guys, like I said before, this is the All-Tech Lansing Mini H2O Rugged Bluetooth Speaker. I found this at Target for $39.99, and I think it's a good pickup. It's IP67 waterproof, sandproof, everything proof. Claims it floats in water, has 6 hours of battery life, and hands-free speakerphone functionality. Flipping it over to the back, it shows that it's waterproof, shockproof, everything proof again, has 6-hour battery life with built-in rechargeable battery, hand-free speakerphone functionality like I said before, and Bluetooth pairing to any Bluetooth-enabled device, more likely your smartphone. Ultimate portability with a mini H2O clip, and it can easily fit in your pocket. And it also is available for all devices. First look at the bottom of the box. It contains a mini H2O rugged Bluetooth speaker, a USB cable, 3.5mm cable, quick start guide, warranty information, and a belt clip, which we'll look at that here in just a second. I'll open up the box here and we'll see what's inside. First, we'll open up the box with my knife here, and after we open up the box, we're first going to see the warranty information as long as a quick start guide. The quick start guide is pretty self-explanatory. It'll show that it has buttons and how to charge and everything like that, along with your 1-year warranty card. First, here's the belt clip. To me, it's a pretty small belt clip, but it could be fairly durable. Next is your USB cable. Your just standard micro USB that you get with any kind of normal phone that isn't an iPhone to charge up the speaker. Next is your 3.5mm audio jack. If you want to, you can plug it straight into your phone and listen without the Bluetooth capability. Pulling out the speaker, the speaker has a nice design with a metal belt loop clip on the top of it with a power button, a subtraction, and a plus button for lowering and raising your volume. The speaker seems durable with a polyurethane plastic coating, as long as the bottom with a cover to cover up your power, your charging port, and your 3.5mm jack port. Alright guys, now that we have it all unboxed, why don't we try giving it a sound test here. So, we're just going to click the power indicator here by turning it on.
Powering on. Welcome to All-Tech Lansing.
Well, that was impressive. Now it looks like we got a red and blue indicator light, like it's trying to match up with Bluetooth here. So, I'm just going to hook it up to my computer real quick and we'll see if we can play a song. This is Break Free. Cloud said that was pretty damn good. All around, personally, I don't know how you guys heard it through the, you know, through the camera and everything. This thing packs some surprisingly bass. It just kind of blew me away. Like, I just kind of felt the table, and it was kind of shaking my table here, and I just, this can easily slide into my pocket. Like, it's so small and compact, and that Altec, they fit everything inside of this, and I honestly was not expecting this at all. Unbelievable that I can maybe easily just hook this to my pocket, my belt loop, backpack, or anything like that. And awesome if you want to, you know, go and hang out with some friends or do something like that small, you have a small speaker to listen to music to. I'm assuming it gets pretty loud because I turned it up a little bit and I thought it was pretty loud in here. Hopefully this stands up to the waterproof test, which we will be testing here shortly. We're gonna go outside and we're going to, you know, do some water testing, do some drop tests and maybe some dirt tests and stuff like that. And we'll hook it back up to our phones and everything. We'll see if it plays music still. So let's do that. Hey guys, we're back outside here, and we're gonna take the speaker and we're gonna put it through some dirt tests, a stair test, and even a water test. It said it is floatable, so I guess we'll see if it worked after I drop it in the water and if it actually floats. So, why not do nothing? Here we go. Well, I would say it sounds pretty normal to me. I think that it passed the water test, and obviously it still floats in the water. So it's obviously a good sign, and even though it can still fit in your pocket like it's nothing. So now we're gonna go move on to the dirt test. We're gonna try to roll down this dirty hill to test the dirt proof in the speaker. So when my assistant's ready, he'll roll down the hill. Let's hopefully that gets dirty. I mean, I think it is dirty because it sticks to the silicone, but, you know, just like anything, if you roll down a dirty hill. So, we're going to play a song now and, of course, test if it works. Bass seems like it works. The sound sounds the same. You know, I don't think there's too much damage done, but what really matters is the dirt got inside or not. And, you know, I don't feel anything falling out or anything like that, and the sound feels pretty good. So always sing some vocals here. You got a face not spoiled by beauty. I have some scars from where I've been. All right, guys, we're here at an outdoor auditorium now, and we're going to take the speaker, and we're gonna roll it down the stairs, detect the shockproof of it, you know, and see if it can land and the durability of rolling down the stairs. So my assistant here is just gonna roll it down the stairs, not too hard, but to get it down the stairs. Looks good to me, let's test it out. So we just picked it up and it looked like it did take a little bit of damage from the stairs. Looks like it took some rugged on the corner from the rubber on the speaker, and it looks like it damaged the belt clip, but I don't think the belt clip was very strong to begin with. So of course we're gonna play a song and see if it still works. It sounds and feels. It feels like the bass is working to me. It sounds good to me. Let's see if some vocals. Every breaking wave on the shore tells the next one there'll be one more. All right, sounds like it works good to me. And then we're gonna head back on inside, and I'll just kind of give some closing thoughts and comments about the speaker. All right, we're back inside here now, and just thinking about this speaker and having it only be $40 when I picked it up at Target, it really gave me the bang for my buck. It's very loud, very durable. Hell, it even floats in water. I mean, I don't know many speakers that do that. I know it's not the Beats Pill, any Bose speaker, or anything like that, but this speaker's good all around. Maybe you're traveling, maybe you're just hanging out with friends, maybe you're just at a gathering, or maybe you're just sitting at your desk working on some stuff, working the grind, and you're doing everything like that, and you just want to listen to some music. I think this speaker is all around perfect for just a little gift for maybe a friend, or even for yourself in the end. So, if you like this speaker, go out and get it, go buy it. Ask your parents for money, go get money, get a job, whatever you have to do. If you like the speaker, go get it. I encourage you to get things you like. I hope you liked the video today. Please subscribe and click the like button for me if you want more content. Let's get my channel going. Thanks. Have a good one.